So the purpose of Backus Norform is to be able to precisely describe exactly the language in a way that's very simple and very concise. So each rule has the form like this, where on the left side there's a non-terminal. Non-terminal means something that we're not finished with. All the words written in blue in the grammar are non-terminals. Sometimes they're written with brackets around them. I've just used blue to distinguish the non-terminals like this. Then there's an arrow. And then on the right side, there's a replacement. The replacement can be anything. It can be a sequence of non-terminals like here, that sentence can be replaced with subject followed by verb followed by object. It can be one non-terminal like here. It can also be a terminal. And the terminals I've written in black. What's special about the terminals is they never appear on the left side of a rule. Once we get to a terminal, we're done. We're finished. There's nothing else we can replace it with. So all the rules have this form. We can form a sentence by starting from some non-terminal, usually whichever one is written at the top left, in this case, the one I called sentence, and then by following the rules, we keep replacing non-terminals with their replacements until we're left with only terminals. So here's an example, starting from sentence, using the grammar above, we can start with sentence. We only have one rule to choose from where sentence is on the left side. So we're going to replace sentence with subject, verb, object. Now we have a lot of choices. We can pick any of the non-terminals we have left, find a rule where that non-terminal is on the left side. We can pick any of the rules where it's on the left side and do the replacement. So I'm going to start with the left one. We'll pick subject, and we only have one replacement rule for subject. We can replace subject with noun. The others stay like they are, so we still have verb, and we still have object. Now we can keep going. We can pick the first one again. It's still a non-terminal, so we can still do replacements. With noun, we've got three choices. We can pick any one of those choices. I'm going to pick the first one. We'll replace noun with the terminal, I. Now we've got a terminal. We're done with that replacement. Verb and object stay the same. I'm running out of space, so I'm not going to write them again, because now we can use rules to replace verb. As a separate step, we're going to find a rule that matches verb. We have two choices. I'll pick the second one and replace verb with like. We still have object. Object's a non-terminal, so we have to keep replacing it until we're done. We have one rule for object. We can replace object with noun. Now we have three rules for noun. I'm going to pick the second rule and replace noun with Python. So what I've done here is what's called a derivation. And a derivation just means starting from some non-terminal, follow the rules to derive a sequence of terminals. We're done when we have only terminals left. And we can derive a sentence in the grammar. In this case, we produce the sentence, I like Python. But there are lots of other sentences we could have produced starting from the same non-terminal if we pick different rules to follow.